hatch is open. Chris Hadfield, now aboard the International Space Station.
Get it running. Here we go. Many people have asked me why I did it. Nobody's ever asked me to go through it and sort of talk the technical details.
It's kind of fun to do.
If you sing a song about sunset, I think you do a lot better job of singing that song if the sun is setting beside you.
Ground control to Major Tom.
To be able to sing Space Oddity while living off the planet, it gets into your voice and gets into how you're interpreting the music. As a result, I think it made not only a more interesting visual, but it definitely changed the way I sang the song. I think it really was the way the song should always have been sung on board a spaceship. If Mr. Bowie could have been there, he would have done a far better job.
Though I'm past 100,000 miles, I'm feeling very still.
The station's noisy, and so you need a quiet place to record. There is no studio on a spaceship, but I experimented and found the quietest place was in my little tiny sleep pod, just a little wider than my shoulders. And that's where I did my vocals and the guitar work.
And I'm floating in a most peculiar way. And the stars look very different.
Life on a spaceship is almost unimaginably busy. You're running 200 experiments running a spaceship. So if you're going to do a personal project, you normally do it once everybody's gone to sleep, and you don't want to bug anybody else. So I did this whole thing completely by myself. I would take the camera, clamp it to the wall, have a look, think it's about right, and then sing along with myself floating through the shots. But then I thought I need some motion shots. So I just took the camera, held onto it, and then just floated around inside the laboratories. This shot in the cupola was really hard to light. I only had one take for that entire shot. I just took one light, stuck it right here, one light, stuck it right here, turned them on, and then I couldn't see anything. So I kind of fumbled and hit record on the camera, hoping that whatever was behind me on the world was about the right balance of lighting. And amazingly enough, the lighting came out perfect. And when the folks were making the movie Interstellar and they were trying to decide how to light Matt McConaughey's face, they actually copied this shot here because they thought the lighting balance of the glow of the world and the glow in my face was some sort of normal space thing. But it was a one try only, and I was really happy that the balance came out the way it did.
Though I've flown 100,000 miles, I'm feeling very still.
By the time I landed, it had only been out less than 24 hours. It had already been seen 7 million times. Technical things are interesting and ideas are interesting, but sometimes the only real way to communicate with people is artistically.
He provided the most intimate view of an astronaut's life the world has ever seen.
And more than 27 million people have seen him in space singing David Bowie.
That's not quite as high as Gangnam Style.
Maybe if he'd only danced like a horse, we would have more science funding.
David Bowie himself called it the most poignant version of the song he had ever heard. How did that make you feel?
I didn't know he said that. Really? That's. Yeah. I got an email from him, but I hadn't heard that. That's lovely to hear.
We did email back and forth, and he really loved this version of his song. Said it was the most poignant version ever made. And I think a lot of people now, when they think of the song Space Oddity, they don't just think of the versions that he did in the 60s and 70s. They also sort of close the whole loop with the version that I did on the space station in 2013.
If you dare, this is Major Tom to ground control. I'm stepping through the door.
And now, knowing just how sick David Bowie was, it makes me doubly happy that I could participate in something that not only honored the song itself, but also that it gave him a sense of a complete circle of life to have had Space Oddity come all the way around to be recorded on a spaceship.
Planet Earth is blue, and there's nothing left to do.
The fact that it brought a smile to David Bowie's face is a source of contentment for me for the rest of my life.